Hi, this is a short video about installing Orion on Node.js. We've got a bit of information already at our Orion wiki page, and this will go through a few of those steps. So I've got Node.js already installed on my Raspberry Pi, this one here. So I'll just log into it. It's running over the wireless network, and I'll simply type npm install Orion. The video has omitted a few of the steps, but essentially all the packages that Orion requires are downloaded and then installed, and we're ready to go. First, I'm going to show you the workspace directory that I want to browse when I'm using Orion. I've got a few Node examples in there already. So what I'm going to do is edit the orion.conf or conf file in the Node modules directory. I'll change that to be that home pi workspace directory that I want to browse, and you can really change that to anything that you want on your file system. Then I just do npm start Orion. Orion will start up and listen on the default port, which is 8081. Then I just switch to the browser and head to that address. So there you can see it's viewing those three folders that I pointed to in the workspace directory on my home folder. And here you can select files and edit them and do file operations, create folders, create files, copy, move them around. And by default, we have syntax highlighting and content assist and other things for JavaScript files. So you can see that this is a very simple Express Node application. And what we're going to do is show you the shell, which is a way to run applications on that target file system. So that related link takes me to the directory where I was editing that file. We do an ls and we can see the various files in that directory. And then we can just do a node start app.js and that will run that application. So this essentially starts another node process on my Raspberry Pi to run that application. In this case, it starts up that very, very, very simple Express application that's listening on port 3000 and says hello from Orion. Another one of the extensions on the node version of Orion is the ability to debug applications. So we'll stop this process that's already listening on that port and instead we'll debug the same application. So it's node debug app.js. That starts up Node Inspector. Takes a bit of time to get that process up and running. And same thing when we click on the URL. The first time takes a bit of a hit to load all the resources. But once it's there, it stops. It sets a breakpoint immediately at the initial entry point. We can set an additional breakpoint when it's about to send the response. So we can show that by going to the web page, refreshing. You can see that it's waiting for the response. We'll go back to the Node Inspector and see that it has indeed stopped at our breakpoint. Let's resume, show that the page finished loading. It did. And we can get rid of some pages right now. Let's stop that debugged process. And show you the available commands that we have in our shell here. I've already shown you ls, but you can also get help on the two commands that are extra on our node implementation of Orion, which is help npm, so you can run npm commands, and help node, so that's running and debugging node applications. So if you need to edit files, move them around, you're not limited to JavaScript files. You can edit whatever you want on that target device. So installing Orion on your Node application is a great way to get access to a device without having to use other commands.